Now, when it comes to fashion, you know me, I always enjoy something a little bit sober. Maybe something a little bit with pinstripes on a good day. Well, now, of course, there are moves afoot in the fashion industry. Valentino, the fashion label worn by the likes of Jackie Onassis and Elizabeth Taylor, has been sold to the Qatari royal family. Report price is around $800 million. You can buy a lot of pinstripes for that sort of amount. Valentino isn't the only major company to fall into the Qatari basket. Here at the super screen, let me show you what I mean. This was Harrods, which was, of course, owned by Mohammed Al-Fayed. In 2010, the Qataris bought the iconic department store from Mr. Al-Fayed. And interestingly, on that occasion, the price at over $2 billion, $3 billion, was considered to be very rich and full indeed. Then in 2011, Qatar Sports Investment bought a 70% controlling stake in the French football club Paris Saint-Germain. Now, when you take all these various purchases, along with other ones that have taken a place, you start to see that whether it's the sovereign fund or the sports fund or the culture fund or just the Qatari royal family, they are buying big in an effort to diversify the economy. John Defterios, our good friend from Abu Dhabi, told me that today's big buy, Valentino, is a perfect fit for Qatar's shopping tastes.
Richard, I think it's fair to say they like to have high-profile purchases, also with a mix of high value. So this latest purchase of Valentino, they got at a discount. Premier bought that brand for about $3 billion. It was a much bigger basket of brands, but they stripped it out. They have Missoni and Valentino. It has a very high profile, but it's undervalued. They thought the same when they bought Harrods, the big retail store, for $2 billion. Many thought they overpaid for it, but they've managed it well, and they're starting to extract value from it. Paris Saint-Germain is a football club. Some would say that's an ego purchase, but they see extracting value over the long term, and they're sitting on a vast wealth, Richard, of at least $75 to $80 billion with a very small population.
Okay, but those companies that you to which you refer, I know the idea is to diversify away from oil and gas and carbon fuels, but you can't build an economy. The revenues won't come in. The value won't be there from the Valentinos and Harrods of this world. You need big real industries.
Well, they would probably differ you with that strategy, with what you're suggesting. They like to have a nice real estate portfolio along with some of the big brands they've been purchasing. They've made some strategic purchases to transfer technology over. For example, that stake in the London Stock Exchange is something they're partnering with the Qatar Stock Exchange, and they want to be the reinsurance market of the Middle East and, in fact, of the globe. So some of these are big purchases they'd like to put into the portfolio because they have so much money to work with, very high-profile purchases that we talked about, but they like to also sneak in and buy things that are undervalued, like Barclays Bank. They took a big stake, sold it at a very high value, and now hold a much smaller stake. They've done that with Porsche. They've done that with Volkswagen. Obviously, some of those things don't transfer to the Middle East, but they can make an argument, Richard, that their portfolio is growing in the meantime as well.
And whilst you and I have been talking, the wells have been producing morning, noon, and night, the money just keep rolling in.
Yeah, that's a very good way of putting it. And Qatar is the extreme case of that. They only have 300,000 people to take care of in a population of just 1.6 million overall. That's including the expats. But this country is producing the equivalent of 5 million barrels a day, the gas equivalent, if you had that in oil. They are sitting in a pretty position. They have the third largest gas reserves. People cannot invest in Iran right now in that giant field that they share. So the Qataris are pumping very quickly. It's also worth noting, this country, Richard, almost went bankrupt in the 1980s, and the Emir made a big bet on natural gas and LNG, and it's paying off handsomely right now.
John Defterios of Global Exchange, talking to me from